Are you tired of plain and boring Markdown text in your SwiftUI apps? Look no further than Markdown UI. This powerful library is compatible with the GitHub flavored Markdown spec and can display a wide range of elements, including images, headings, lists, block codes, code blocks, tables, and more. And with its theming features, you can customize the look and feel of your Markdown text to match your app's style. In this video, we'll take a closer look at the Markdown UI GitHub repository and show you how to get started with this must-have library for your SwiftUI projects. So first of all, let's take a look at how the default SwiftUI Markdown works. I have already added here some example Markdowns that we are going to use throughout this tutorial. Make sure to check out the captions down below. What SwiftUI already has is some built-in Markdown, for example, some bold right over here. You can see now it is a bold, or we can just go for italics. There are some basics Markdown provided by SwiftUI, but I want more. I want headings, I want links, I want captions, I want all of what Markdown has to offer. So in order to do that, we are going to use an amazing GitHub repository, and that is called Swift Markdown UI by Gonzalez Real. Guil Gonzalez. Hopefully I didn't butcher your name. Sorry about that. So what you need to do, and you can take a look at the documentation. It's amazing. What we are going to do here today is I'm going to show you how you can install it, and we are going to have some nice examples with it. So what you want to do is copy out the HTTPS link and go ahead and select your project, package dependencies, a plus over there, paste it. And currently I'm going to use 2.1.0, I believe, but up to next major version 2.0.0. So let's add that to our package. There we go, 2.1.0. Looking to learn SwiftUI and to connect to an amazing network of like-minded developers? Join us at SwiftUI Nation. You'll gain exclusive content, live group coaching sessions, and build lifelong friendships while taking your SwiftUI skills to new heights. Let's grow and succeed together. So now we want to use this awesome dependency. Let's go to our content view. Let's just have a little bit more space over here. And first thing that I'm going to do is just import Markdown UI. So it's called Markdown UI. I know the repository name is Swift Markdown UI, most probably just for searching reasons, but you want to import Markdown UI. And what I want to do is just have a little bit of text editor area where I can input my raw Markdown. And also I want to have area for the Markdown so I can just see the actually edited Markdown. So what should we do? Well, first of all, let's remove all of this and add a Markdown. And let's just experiment with the current Markdown that we have right over here. Markdown string zero. There we go. Let's see that. There we go. SwiftUI Nation. SwiftUI Nation is where SwiftUI developers learn, build, and connect. Join now. Of course, this link already works if you want to check it out. Build it on the simulator and it will take you to Safari. It's really, really amazing. And if you do want to join SwiftUI Nation, go ahead and check out the link in the description. Now, let's take a look at the second one. So Markdown string one. And so this is basically to showcase how you can add code. So with the backticks. Okay, and then let's just have Markdown string two right over there. And this is just for a quote. Okay, so what we want to do is, have a little bit of theme. So Markdown theme, there we go. And you can add margin, improve image provider, just type out Markdown and you will have all of your details. Now, what you could do is add in here. So we are going to have Doxy, GitHub, or Basic. Basic is the default one. So let's take a look at a GitHub right over there. Let's see how this preview provider will refresh itself. And currently we have the, oh, it just crashed, okay. Currently we have our default, the basic markdown for our string. Let's just add a dot right over here and let's see, let's also refresh. And there we go, we have actual quote in GitHub style. Now you can also set up your own markdown theme for your blocks, for your code, for your text. There are two types here, text and code blocks, but we are going to make it even a little bit better. Now we are going to add a text editor, and let me just scroll a little bit up here. We are going to create a private state variable. Let's just call it text and an empty string. And we are going to add that right over there. Okay. I'm going to go back to maybe basic so we can see the changes later on. So what we want to do is add a text editor to our safe area edges bottom part. So let's just add, because this markdown is just a pull in view, we want to make it a push out view, therefore, and also I want it to be of alignment top and leading. I'm going to add a frame to this. So dot frame, and we're going to have a max width of dot infinity, meaning that it's going to stretch all the way out to the sides of my screen, and then max height of dot infinity, so it's going to stretch all the way up, and then I'm going to have an alignment, and the alignment will be top leading. Okay. Also, I want to add a padding, so it would just look a little bit nicer. We're going to have that Y space. And now it's time to add our text editor. So we're going to not add a text editor as a V stack at the bottom. We are going to add that to the safe area inset. Therefore, when we show the keyboard, this will be pushed all the way up. So dot safe area inset, and we are going to use this edge with the content. The edge would be a bottom, and then the content, let's add also a divider. So we want to have a VSEC right over here with a divider, and also I'm going to add in here a text editor with our binded text state variable. And let's just have a frame. Text editors do need to have a frame. So I'm going to set the frame height to be 100. The width will be, of course, full screen. And let's just have also a little bit of padding at the bottom. So padding dot bottom. So it would look nice on an iPhone SE or those devices that do not have a notch. Okay. So we did set this up. So let's see what do we have at this point. So what I'm going to do is just type out hello. And as you can see, just typing out hello, this is the body. But what if I add in here some markdown? So let's have a header. There we go, that's a header. And then let's have a subheader. There we go. It's really, really nice. I believe I do need to have that separate. Okay, subheader, really nice. Let's just see if we can have a little bit of code. So first of all, inline coding, you must import, let's see, markdown UI to use it. Okay, it's really, really nice. This is the default one, so the basic markdown theme. Let's just go for maybe Doxy. So, I just selected basic again. So Doxy, Let's see if it's going to render something also. And this is for our doxy. Let's just see this with some dark appearance. And yeah, that would be really, really nice. Let's add in here. And if you change this to, well, let me just copy this out. Let's see, because I don't want, well, let's just change this to GitHub so we can see a little bit better. It's really, really nice. Also, we can have some quotes. Quote goes here. It's really, really nice. It's amazing of how easy it is to just set up Markdown with simple text. This will definitely save you a lot of time setting up a complex text-based UI. Now, if you want to learn how to save even more time and how to be more productive, go ahead and check out my latest video on the Pomodoro technique. It's right over here.